Oh, I gotta read his brain! Oh, Boar, how you've been gotten in the brain? Oh, your brain must be so frigged up right now because my arrow's inside of your brain. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some more Stranded Deep, peeps. Hope you guys are having a good day. I am having a great day, and we're back on our beautiful deserted island doing some stuff and things. Thanks so much for coming to hang out with me. Thanks so much for continuing to show your support on all the Stranded Deep stuff and things. Make sure if you like the video, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button, peeps. And if you're new and you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe as well. So in the last episode, we discovered rain. What else is there to talk about? And we did a little bit of building, guys. And it was awesome. We built a new little area in our house over there, and we discovered kindling. But there was other stuff and things that went on. Are you a spoiled sardine now? I don't think they spoil anymore. So there's been some other stuff and things that went on. I went ahead after we recorded the episode, and I went to the Stranded Deep website. I took a look at some of the updates and kind of wanted to see the stuff and things that had changed. I was especially interested in trying to figure out what was going on with our sardines. So, you know, I don't know if you guys know this about me. Some of you guys don't realize this. Like, I don't really like to go to the websites and read about this stuff. I like to kind of try to figure it out in game, but some of it's a little bit tricksy. So it's a little bit hard to figure out in game. But one of the things that we're going to need to do today is build a Kniffy, because we're going to need that Kniffy in order to skin these fish. It's a new mechanic. Oh, you know what would probably be easier? I was going to pick them all up with and drag them, but I could just pick them up like this. So it's a new mechanic. New stuff and things are happening that we can go ahead and skin our fish. So let's drop fish, spot fish everywhere right there. And then we're going to do this. We're going to figure this out. Oh, also, if I'm not mistaken, the boar and the snake are now able to be killed, skinned, and they do create meat. There's the boar right there. So we have an action-packed afternoon of stuff and things to get done. We've got to go ahead and make the Kniffy. We've got to go ahead and skin our fishes. We've got to make a bow and arrow, and we've got to hunt a boar down. I don't even know if we'll be able to do it. I've never hunted on a boar. I'm not a boarologist, but there's one thing I do know. We'll need a bow and arrow. So, all right, first things first, we're going to need a Kniffy. I bet you we need one of those thingies. What are they called? Stone tools in order to make this. We need a stone tool, wooden stick, and a lashing, of which we have six. So go ahead and grab a stick because they're not close enough for our crafting. And then we will head over here like a sew, craft a stone tool, nail the days to camp stuff, Kniffy craft, bam. Oh, yeah, we got one. Pick it up. What is it like? Yeah, don't mess with me. See? I'm a ninja. I have several different knife angles that I will attack with. This is one. That's the same one. Wait, it's not. It's all the same every time, isn't it? I thought it was different. Okay. So, all right, let's head over here and take a look at this. See how this is going to work out. E to pick up. Hold E to skin. All right. I don't know. This is going to be gross, man. We're going to get fish guts all over us. All right, here we go. I did one of them. I'm going to do another one here so you can see. I didn't want you guys to be too grossed out by it. I had to do a test. Let's go ahead and check it out. Ready? Oh, God. Oh. He says, oh, it's disgusting. And then the fish just, like, disappears. I'm not going to lie to you guys. It looks like he stabbed himself in the ding-a-ling and then, like, cutting. It looks like it's, like, what is that? Sippaku? Where you, like, cut yourself and kill yourself? Oh, God, this is disgustingly gross. I love the sounds that he makes, man. That's awesome. All right, let's do these guys up here. I wonder whose voice they used. I think it's Neil Patrick Harris. All right, let's go ahead and just get this guy done. Gross. All right, so now we've got how many fish skins? Eight. We've got eight of these guys. So, and as we saw before, last time, we can't really, like, drop them in here. Can we? Oh, this makes it a lot easier. You can kind of drop them in there. Oh, that one, that was easy. It was way easier than the fish. Did they all get in there? All right, they did. Let's head over here and grab some palm fronds real quick. Make sure we have enough to refuel our fire. I'm actually going to grab them from this side. Let's grab four of these guys. Refuel our fires, and then we'll light them with kindling here. So let's go ahead and do this. Okay, that's full. All right, that's full. And then we'll just drop. Oh, use them all? Okay, that's fine. That's how you're going to be. Pick up our kindling. And then we got to light our fire. This is probably the highlight of my day. I just like to get up in the morning. You know, there's nothing like getting up in the morning, on a stranded, deserted island, and you're craving like a cup of coffee and a bagel, and you're like, you know what I'm going to do instead? I'm just going to play with a stick for a minute and hopefully light a fire so I can smoke my weirdly shaped fish fillets. You know what's weird? Those little fish are tiny, and these little meat fillets are humongous. So, all right, it doesn't matter. Six or a half dozen. We've got our meat. It's smoking right now, and we're just going to leave it over there to smoke to do its thing. The next order of business is we've got to make the bow and arrow. Stick and lashing. Pretty straightforward. So let's go ahead and head over here. Can we do it right here? Okay, we can. Nailed it, ace to KB style. We made a bow. Pretty much a hunterologist. So let's go ahead and take a look at the arrow. I think we're going to need stone tools. So I want to make a few of these arrows. Let's go ahead and... What am I doing? This guy. Stone tool. Craft. Bam. Stone tool. I wish you could craft more than one. It would be amazing if you could craft more than one. There's three. I also feel like you should be able to get more than one stone tool from one rock. But that's just me. That's just me, you know? I'm just saying. All right. There's five. Do we need... ten. Let's do 10. I was wondering if we should do just 5. I think this is... Oh, does it take 2 rocks each time? 2 rocks for one little thing? That makes it make no sense, not at all. All right, so that's all the ones we can do. Let's craft all the arrows we can craft. Remember, these guys stay in the air for some reason. We're going to make a little design with them. It's going to be the most amazing design of arrows that I've ever done. I'm pretty sure. All right, check it out, guys. There's all of our arrows, our amazing arrows, ready to be picked up. Look at that. What an amazing design. You could actually do some really cool stuff with that aesthetically in the game if you wanted to put them in and around your base. Just never pick them up after. So, all right, guys. All right, we've got all of our arrows. We've got our bow. Oh, I think they changed this a little bit. All right, now we've just got to find the boar, which we saw it over here. I don't know if it's like persistent. Whoa. We're like the boar, you know, it's like always in the same area. I think it like appears, it disappears. I have a feeling that that's the case. I don't know if it's just alive and it wanders around. I don't think that that's so. Let's get up on top of the mountain top here. Oh, is that a boar? No, that's a leaf. And see, is that a boar? Oh, it is. That's the boar right there. Okay. We're going to sneak up on it, guys. Don't make a sound! Okay, that was a little loud. All right, here we go. Oh, I got to read his brain! Oh, boar, how you've been gotten in the brain? Oh, your brain must be so frigged up right now because my arrow's inside of your brain. Here we go. It's our chance. Oh, we got a second one. How many shots does it take to get this boar down? Oh, baby, we're chasing him down, man. Oh, he's super far away. Okay, there he... What is that digging noise? Why is there a digging noise? Also, why is this boar not dead? There's no way. Like, a singular arrow would not take this guy out. This is crazy. Look how many friggin' arrows is in this guy. All right, we're just gonna wait for him to calm down again. I'm not gonna, like, shoot him more. I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna track him. I'm gonna track the boar. Eventually, he's going to chill out. There he goes. Oh, yeah, baby. We did it. Nailed it. Ace that can't be stopped. Oh, we can pick up all of our arrows off of it. That's super cool. We've got to go around and get the rest of our arrows, too. All right. Dead boar. Look at him, man. Oh, what a feast you will become. Dead boar. Thank you, gods of Stranded Deep, for special boar meat treats. I will grab your body right now. Hold on. Let's go like this. Oh, give it to me, boar. Oh, yeah. Come with me, buddy. We've got to go back around here. Let's go back and get our arrows. Oh, you want some of this, dumb boar? You made me waste arrows. Where are they all? Second boar! Oh, you're going to have a little buddy. We're going to have a little buddy for you, dead boar. Let's do this. Oh, wait, that's not what we want to do. Oh, he's freaked out. You stay here. Don't you move 1 inch. Where did he go? Where did he go? Did he go in the water? No, there's no way it's a sea boar. The rare, elusive sea boar. All right, there's one of our arrows right there. Let's go ahead and grab this guy. There's another one There's the boar. There's another arrow right there. But hold on. Oh, raid your brain! Ha 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 ha, stupid boar! I don't know if you guys know this, but I'm pretty much an expert at shooting boars in the brain. All right, there he is. Does he calm down again? This is way easier if you don't chase them. Ha ha ha, right in your little side place, whatever they call that on a boar. Your flank, I flanked you with an arrow. Are you feeling sleepy? Oh, I missed. Okay, that's fine, because we can just pick him up. That's the best thing about this. Are you still there, boar? All right, you stay right there. All right, where did he go? Oh, I think I got him. I think I beamed him. I don't know. Yeah, he's got triple arrows in him. Oh, he's getting sleepy. I can tell. Oh my gosh, boar. Do your little boar dance. All right, calm down, boar. Calm down. There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Are you ready? Bring the buck awake in the most vulnerable spot. We got him. Oh yeah, so it takes four arrows to kill a... Oh, he's doing a jig. Oh no, he's still alive a little bit. Oh no, don't do that. Boar, no, is everything okay? All right, just hang out. Why is his little leg moving still? Oh no, he's just still twitching from the... It's the death throes of the boar. All right, guys, we gotta head back over this way and grab our other boar. And now we have two boars. I'm gonna be bored of boars. Okay, so let's grab our boars and then we'll bring them back to base here to our home area. And we'll get our Kniffy out and we'll skin him up and see what we can get out of him. I think the dinging noise we heard also, you still with me, boar? I think the dinging noise we heard was, whoa, I'm flying on a boar. You are super amazing magic boar flight. Boar of flight, take me on my journey. I can't get him. How do we do that? Let's do that again. We're flying on a boar. Oh, I took damage. Boar flight is super dangerous. We can't do that until we get feather falling boots. Where'd the other boar go? Oh, he's over here. Okay. No, don't try to get under my legs, man. I don't need to die from boar flight. Okay, we get, okay. We just gotta stay down a little bit, I think. Oh my gosh, guys. Don't make me fly, boar. Where'd you go? No, don't try that. Man, this boar's sneaky. He's a sneaky McSneakerton doing all sorts of stuff and things trying to make me fly in the air and kill myself. That's just how they always get you. That's how they get you in the streets. They start off with a little taste of flight. The wild boars. This doesn't make any sense at all, this story, but it's true, and that's a lie. Where did the other boar go? Oh, there they are. Okay, twin boars. All right, let's get them up over here. Skin. Okay, this is going to be gross, guys. Don't watch. Maybe you don't want to watch. How many boars did we get? We only got one meat? What? Oh, we got to do it multiple times.
Oh, gross.
Okay, so... Huh? All right, I got to say, if a sardine gives you one meat, but a boar gives you two... Oh, look at all of our smoked meats. Smoked small meat. Give me all this. Okay, since we got our fire going. Oh, this is different. It's medium meat. Ah, ha, 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 I see now. No, come to me, medium meat. Enjoy being smoked. All right, so this is definitely a learning experience, ladies and gentle peeps. Look at these little hockey pucks of meat. They look so so excited to eat one. It looks so moist and delicious, or possibly like a dry leather shoe bottom. Let's take a look. We need food and water. All right, so here's the test. We got a test here. Two haunches. Okay, gave us one. So from the small meat, we get one food deal, and we're good to go there. So then from the bucket, we got a drink three times. All right, let's stick this over here. The easiest way to tell if your bucket has water in it. Okay, that bucket has no water in it. So we're gonna put that up there and just wait. We still have some fresh water in these buckets from when it rained. We got our super amazing meat now. This is kind of cool. I'm down for this. I'm down to like make food this way. This is a neat way to make food. You know what we need to make though is a refrigerator. We need a refrigerator as well to go with our meat. All right, so we got a little food stash right over here. Maybe we'll stick our meat right here. And we gotta think about that refrigerator. We'll wait for this stuff to smoke up. What time is it today right now? It's about 4 o'clock. The sun is on its way down. I think I'm going to go ahead, wait for this meat to smoke up, think a little bit about how we could build a refrigerator, and I'll be our beast, peeps. Good morning. It's raining. It's raining again. Free water. No bucket. Give me that. No. You don't. I don't care about you on the freaking fire thing. Here, get that over there. Are you staying upright? Okay, everybody stop. Everything. Raining. Give me that bucket right now. Okay. Drop it. No, here. Drop it sideways. Dump out all your water. Dump it out. All yours. Okay. Give it to me. Over here. I hope it rains every day. So far, it's rained every day. Don't tell the devs. Don't anybody email the devs. Stop it. Stop emailing the devs right now. Stop, stop, stop. No, 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 no. I like this. Free water is the way to go. I am super excited about it, and I think that is one of the best things that happened. Now, you know, one of the things in the last episode, we had survived for what? Now, yesterday, or the last time I recorded, it was 16 days. In the last episode, it was 16 days. And then it's been 17 days. Now, the reason that it didn't rain for 16 days wasn't because it only rains once every 16 days. The reason that it didn't rain is because there was no weather in this game. They had taken it out. So it's really hard to keep up with all the different changes that get made. But yeah, there wasn't any rain in the game. And so now they've added it back in. And so far, it's rained twice in 2 days, which is pretty much obviously going to be changed. Because now, buckets are not the most valuable thing in the world anymore. They used to be the most valuable thing you could possibly get. Are we fully full? No, we need to eat one of our little meats. I don't want to eat a big meat because I'm not sure how many haunches that it takes care of. But I also want to heal. So we've got to eat a little meat. Hockey puck, my favorite. So, yeah, it used to be that buckets were the most valuable thing in the game. Way, way more valuable than they should be. Because without them, I mean, you'd have to eat so many coconuts in order to survive, and eventually you just wouldn't be able to. So you needed buckets to make water. You couldn't even make crops without them. Now that it rains every day, I'm pretty sure the rain refills the crop water. Yeah. So we haven't got any problems there. We still aren't really making any fruit. There's definitely some balancing that needs to go on here. Oh, a piece of fruit. I can't believe it. Oh, give it to me. Oh, is there one on each tree now? Whoa, it only took like how many episodes? I don't even know. Well, we have 3 pieces of fruit now. So we're going to take these. We are never going to drop them. Because if we do, I think they'll spoil. So we just have to hold them in our inventory. And we're going to drop our bow. And we're going to drop our 9 arrows right here. 10 arrows, pardon me, like so. And our kniffy we only need if we're going to skin things. Now, I'm wondering if you can skin things with a machete. It seems kind of like you might be able to. We have a couple of those guys over there. All right. So anyway, I was thinking at the end of the, or towards the end of the episode now that we've got unlimited water and stuff and things, we do need to make a refrigerator. I feel like we need a kitchen. That's kind of what we need is a kitchen. Let's get open our door here. This is our old bedroom. I'm thinking we're going to move our bedroom. All right, so let's see if we can do this. So we have, we had a kniffy here and it's gone. What happened to our kniffy knife? Did they take the knives out? I don't know. We definitely had a kniffy on top of the engine that was a little side table in our bed. Did it like glitch out and fall or something like that? I don't see it underneath the house anywhere. I don't know what happened to the kniffy. It's gone. So, all right, anyway, now let's take a look at our bed. So we've got our bed here. We can hold E to interact with it. That just means we're going to sleep. Can we still drag the bed? Okay, we can. All right, come with me, bed. We go into the new bedroom, I think. If this is possible, it will be amazing. All right, we're going backwards. Up. You know what? It would be great. Anytime you're moving, it'd be great if we had a brother. Our brother could come over and help us move. Come here. Because no one really wants to help you move. Except your brother. Your brother has to help you move. Get up here, bed. Come on. Oh, this bed is so heavy. Okay. All right. So now we got to flip you over. Get flipped over, bed. Oh, we almost did it. That was pretty good. I didn't even think we were going to be able to flip it over. All right, hold on. All right. Oh, yes. We did it. All right, now we got to drag it into here. All right. So our bed is in-ish. I really would like to drag it over a little bit. This is so difficult, man. Let me see if we can. Okay. I want to get it right in the middle. I want to get it right in the, so it's centered. Is it centered? Oh, it sure ain't. All right. So we got to move this guy over a little bit. Wait, like so. Why won't you move, bed? And then we gotta move this guy over. This is such a pain in the butt. I don't think we're gonna be able to. All right, our bed might be a little catty-cornered. No, what? Oh no, we made a terrible disaster. All right, bed, just get in the corner as far as you can go. That's gonna be the best option for you. All right, no. All the way in. And then you all the way in. This is so weird. It doesn't want to like move all the time. It's so strange. I think that's going to be it. So that's our bed. Now we got to go ahead and take our engine and drop that. Okay, it's up. We're good to go. We're going to move it over a little bit. This is what I go through for amazing aesthetics. All right, there. There's our bedside table. There's our bed. All right, so what I'm thinking is, like I was saying, over here we need a kitchen. So we're going to need a refrigerator. So that's one of the things we have to build first. So refrigerator obviously needs to be built of metal. I mean, that only makes sense, right? Oh, yeah, stop this. We got to close this guy, and we got to come over here. We got to grab our hammer. Okay. Now, building stuff and things, walls, and we need corrugated wall. We did it. All right, so now let's see if we're able to even place our refrigerator inside of here. We want it to be right here. All right, there's that. And then we're gonna need a refrigerator door. So we need to craft arches, corrugated arch, craft. Nail that ACK, we stopped. All right, this will be the entrance the door, our refrigerator door. Okay, we did it. All right, sweet. So now we gotta make the door. And we don't have any of the steel stuff. So I'm thinking, we'll just make a door, corrugated door, like so. All right, now we've got our door to our refrigerator. And we'll put it right there. All right, sweet. So now we got our refrigerator. This is where we'll put all of our food. It makes perfect sense. I mean, obviously, you have a refrigerator inside your house. Everybody does. So now we just got to pick up our meats. Like so, and we don't need to refrigerate coconuts. I mean, there's like any fruit. You see them in a home, you see them in a fruit basket outside. You know, you don't need to put your fruit in the fridge. You can, but we're gonna put our meat in here. So we're gonna drop this meat, and then hopefully none of this goes through the floorboards. All right, there, close the door. Obviously, this is our refrigerator. It will keep things nice and cold. What else does a kitchen need? And we're back. I added just something really small to our kitchen, as well as having a refrigerator. We also now have a little table. I'll show you how this is gonna work over here. So we've got a little table, and we've got our little knife and a little paper towel to clean our hands off with. And we've got a little faucet. It's a little water faucet. So it puts water, I don't know where this is, a sink too, maybe, I don't know. And so there's our crude Kniffy and our little hand cloth. And then we, you know, it shows over here how we make our coconuts into just the empty drinkable coconuts in the morning and stuff. And then we've got our refrigerator right here. Check it out, guys. And then there's all our meat inside of here. Are we hungry for meat? We are. Let's have a little meat. Hockey puckish. All right, squirt that out of there. It also stopped raining. So we're still down, oh my gosh. We're still down two haunches or two nodules of HPs. Oh, we need to drink a little bit more. All right, that's empty, I think, now. All right, we've got to really just kind of chill out here while we're waiting for our health to come back. But another thing happened, guys. You know, we've been on the island stranded for such a long time. And just recently, I don't know if you remember, we went boar hunting. And we got two boars. And one of them, I've made it our friend. Barry the boar. Barry the boar is here. Look how happy he is, too. And he's going to hang out with us and be our best friend. Barry, come here, man. Yeah, I'm gonna show you the new kitchen that we have. Come on, man. Oh yeah, look how excited he is right there. Look how excited he looks. Yeah, I know, Barry, it's super great. Come on, let's go inside. Here, come here. We're gonna come in here so you can see. All right, let me go ahead and get you over here so you can see exactly what's happening. All right, Barry. See, it's a kitchen. Yeah, I know, it's like a faucet. It looks just like it, doesn't it? I know, that's why I put it there. And then there's a knife and a paper towel. See, you got it. The people at home, they were like, what? I don't get it. No, I know, you got it though. That's why I love you, Barry, because we're best buddies. What's that? Yes, it's a refrigerator, you guessed it. Oh, you want to see it? All right, Hold on, I'll show you the refrigerator. Look, you can open it up like this. See? Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you just put your food in there. I know. It's super great. Are you going to go in? Oh, okay. You can go in the fridge. There you go, man. What, you want to stay in here? Because it's super hot out? That actually really makes a lot of sense. You know what? I'm going to stay in the fridge with you, man. Because it's super chilled in here. Because it's a refrigerator. Barry, you're like my best friend, man. I'm so excited we did some stuff with things. We figured out how to skin stuff today. We went boar hunting today. And we made a new best friend today. And we made a bedroom. And we made a kitchen. Action-packed, stranded deep stuff and things have happened. And that's going to be it for today, peeps. Thanks so much for coming to hang out with me. Make sure if you like the video, please don't forget to show your support and hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite the video as you see fit. And may the stuff and things be with you. Oh, I'm sorry, Barry. Yeah, that's right. We're going to hang out in here. We'll be right back.